salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Okay, just to have a teacher for everyone to each other. So because it's like a black magic, so black clothes also. So just it makes us to understand the topic better. Okay, it's like when you go to Saudi, when you go to Medina, if you study Siraza, for example, the event of Uhud, if you go to the mountain of Uhud, and if they will explain to you, it's like better to understand. So, black, you have got the black, I'm going to explain magic, because it's easier to understand. Okay. So anyway, so black magic, I don't think that we need explanation of what black magic is. Black magic, actually, as you know, we Muslims split into two to explain what black magic is. Okay, so big number of the early scholars, they used to deny the existence, the reality of the black magic, saying that it is only something which affects on your imagination. So it makes you to live in illusion, but it does not have reality. Okay, so for example, you think, so by black magic, there is type of black magic which causes illness. So they say there is not any illness, but by reciting some certain things, you are going to make the person to think that there is pain in some certain places, but it does not occur. And the proof of that is in Quran, Allah says, وَسَحَرُوا أَعْيُنَ النَّاسِ وَاسْتَرْهَبُوهُمْ وَجَاءُوا بِإِفْكٍ عَظِيمٍ. If you remember, when there was like a challenge between Musa alayhi salam and the magician, black magicians, so what was the thing? They brought some cases, the stuff, and then they thrown the stuff into the, like, into the field. Okay? So then what Allah says? Allah says, سَحَرُوا أَعْيُنَ النَّاسِ. They blocked up, they made sahar on the eyes of the people. Means there was not any reality of it, but only it seems to be like that for the people there. Okay? So that is one proof. And the second proof, if you remember, when mushriks came asking, challenging Rasulullah to split moon into two. Do you remember the event? So when they came, Rasulullah prayed, and then just by pointing, moon split into two. It is in Quran. So moon split into two. But then what was the challenge of the Qurayshis? Qurayshis said, Muhammad did sahar on our eyes, so let's wait someone who's coming from outside to ask them. So from here we understand that black magic does not have reality, but it is only eye illusion. So that is one group. It is the group called Mu'tazila. But we are the Sunnah wal Jama'ah, as well as big number of the Hanafi scholars, early scholars, they actually follow this position. And the second group, I do follow that, but the majority of the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, all of Maliki Shafi, they do follow, saying black magic actually does have its own reality. So it's not something related to your eye and illusion, but it actually has got its own reality. Okay? So when you are ill, if it has been caused by black magic that you are ill, so it is illness. Okay? So then, you know, in our time, the science maybe, it may back up the first position. Because, you know, normally, when a person who is affected by the magic which causes illness, if they go to the doctors find nothing in them. It is, in my own experience, 99% of the situations, that what happens. But now, look. One thing is quite obvious, very obvious thing. Do you know, our thought is the biggest weapon against ourselves. Just go to the people who have the illnesses which normally caused by black magic. So it is mainly oncologic illnesses, tumors, different types of things. So you find them before they become ill, they will be into psychological problem, which causes them to think bad all the time. Look, negative thought causes illness, that is 100% certified. Doctors may not accept it, but go to the psychologists, you know. Go to even the Rukia people, okay. It is 100% confirmed that whenever you make bad thought, you become weak, okay. For example, let's suppose I will do black magic on you. But as long as you are making good thought about everyone and anyone and anything also, you will be strong enough to block yourself. Okay, protect yourself. But as soon as you will start thinking bad, so it causes some faults in your body. Okay, then you get that black magic. Or you do some certain sins, mainly related to the sexual things. So then that pulse appears, so then you will get infected. But if you are thinking positively good about people and about everything, or for example, you're not complaining about your life, okay, so you're strong. As well as you're not committing any sins, anyone does black magic, you will not get infected. But it will be hanging around. As soon as you will do one of them two things, thinking negatively, thinking evil, or if you will get engaged into some type of sexual sins, looking, touching, speaking, making, so then that hole appears and then you will get infected. Okay, just keep it from me. It is from my own experience. You may not find it in the books, but it is from my own experience. Okay, so your thought is the greatest weapon against you to create that illnesses which normally we say it is because of black magic. Okay, yeah. Now even for example, do you know the people, even in our herbal medicine, we say that, do you know that a negative tumor, cancerous tumor, so that is Saudawi illness. Before cancer, person becomes Saudawi. One of the causes of Saudawi person that you will be thinking evil and making bad thoughts about the people, about things. Okay, so that is one. Anyway, so we do, majority of our Muslims, we do believe that black magic has got its own reality. It's not only illusion that you see. Of course, there are many types of black magics. One of them is illusion. You see things. Okay, but then does that happen in your brain or does it have a reality? I say both. Okay. So sometimes, normally people who do like effect on your brain, okay, so it's mainly to be done by like numerology or the sense of letters. They control your brain, okay, or, so that is, that does not have reality. You see things, for example, you see something is running after you, you'll be scared. So nothing is in there. If you stay there, like bravely, nothing will come to hit you. Just will go past, nothing is there. So it is, your brain is controlled by numerology or that type of things. Okay, normally what do? They take your name and your mother's name, okay, as well as your date of birth. Okay, and then they convert it into the numbers and then they squeeze it into one, they twist it into one. There are many ways, okay. So even for the treatment from that, we need the same thing, same details. But twisting, like combining, is different. So for the black magic, you have to make it in odd numbers, different type of odd numbers. And for the string, it has got its own way. If you use, even if your intention is good, to do the positive one, to unblock the black magic, but if you use the way of black magic, you know, like combining, multiplying and combining, so it will give a negative effect. Okay, so that's how they will affect on your brain. So then you will start seeing things, but it does not have any, so that is illusion, 100%. Okay, but there is another type of black magic in which they attach some gene on you. How? It could be by anyhow. It could be on your name, or it could be on one of your clothes, or it could be in your house, in one of the rooms. It could be anyhow, okay? And it will start showing itself to you, okay? So, but that has got a reality. So it is real gene, actually.
you see it, but it, because it may change its shape, you know, can show, like, it can show itself to you like maybe snake, big dragon snake, okay, or like one of your relatives, maybe. Okay, I had the case. Some of you guys started doing black magic and look, I'm coughing. I'm sorry, it's okay, we can just have some magician water, please. I had a case in which some lady was affected by black magic. It was actually the second time. Okay, somehow she has eaten, or you know, she went to her relatives, cousins. Okay, and there was some certain she was very like a beautiful lady. Her beauty was famous everywhere. Okay, but she married some like a young man, but others, they wanted to marry her also, but it did not happen. So then people made black magic. How? They fed her. So that black magic is it's such a kind of a black magic. As long as that eaten thing is inside of you, it will stay. Okay, so for you to unblock it, either you have to make that person to release it, okay, or either you have to make the ruqya, which is very tough actually, very difficult, okay, it may take a long time. But just keep in your mind, no any type of black magic can survive after 40 yasins, read within 3 days, sequence. I'm going to explain, don't worry, okay, so anyway. So, she started seeing things, okay? And towards the end of the effect of the black magic, what happened? She started seeing her grandfather and grandmother from both of the sides. Okay, and she used to live, I think, was it 7th floor or 8th floor? Okay, house building is 9th floor building. And then she would see it from behind the window. Okay, but she would see, if she would open the window, she would see like a path. And at the end of the path, gate, open gate, behind the paradise maybe. And just before the gate, her relatives, grandfathers and grandmothers, calling her, saying, come here, we're waiting for you, let's go. And for a few times, they hear craps like this, she wants to jump. Because she saw that there is nothing. Okay? So, but that has got reality. It is jinnat actually. It is not something that happens in your brain, but actually what we see, it is in there. Okay? So if we would have like eyesight, as the people who see the unseen would see them jinnat also. Okay? So it has got reality. Okay? It has got reality. So anyway. So, black magic is actually many things. Now, in terms of the ayat and the hadith of black magic, obviously, there is a surah of Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانَ وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ السِّحْرَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى الْمَلَكَيْنِ بِبَابِلَ هَارُوتَ وَمَارُوتَ وَمَا يُعَلِّمَانِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ حَتَّى يَقُولَا إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ فِتْنَةٌ فَلَا تَكْفُرْ فَتَعَلَّمُوا. So the ayah says Sulaiman, because as you know, Jews and Christians, they say that Sulaiman, he's not a prophet, and he was good king before. But afterwards, he made like a temples for the idols, and he started doing black magic. Okay, so that's what they say. Okay, because as far as I know, no Christians and no Jews, they believe on like prophethood of Dawud al-Islam and Sulaiman. They call them kings, but they call Dawud al-Islam as pious king, righteous king, but his son Sulaiman al-Islam as disbeliever, misguided. Okay? So Allah has a response to that. Allah revealed ayah saying, وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانَ. Sulaiman did not make kufr, وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا. But
them jinnat who used to obey Sulaiman alayhi salam, they are the ones who made kufr. How? If you remember, it is in Israeliyat anyway. So what happened after Sulaiman alayhi salam used to be king of the jinnat also, who dictate, would order them to do things, etc. So then, when he passed away, so jinnat have written a book, and then they do underneath of the throne of Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, and then they placed it there. So all of that was the black magic recitations. And even till now, in Islam, we do have them books, you know. Unfortunately, it is attributed to greatest imams of tasawwuf, mainly Shaykh Ahmad al-Buni and Imam Ghazali. Some of them attributed to Imam al-Qadir Jilani also. All of them are Shakiyya and Kufriya. So what do they do? So because all of them Israeliya did flow into Islam also, am I right? And all of them, because in the beginning of Islam, the first several generations, several centuries, five, 6 centuries of Islam, from straight after the death of Rasulullah, so the other nations, they came into Islam by hypocrisy. They never accepted, big group of them. And then they started dictating things and writing things in the masajid. Okay, as they did with Isa alayhi salam, Saint Paul came to destroy the religion of Isa alayhi salam. So those people came to destroy the religion of Rasulullah alayhi salam. So that type of people, they made up the books. Okay, and then they did attribute it to the imams. The earliest ones, they made up the black magician books attributed to Imam Ali. Okay, so actually, that type of book. So, for example, we have a book called Shamsul Awarif. It's haram to be read. Okay, we have a book called Kanzul Hussein. We have a book called aqeeda Jafra. All of them are black magic. It's not permissible to be read. Okay, now a Hanafi madhab, even anyone who finds it, it is fast to be burnt. All of that is the like a recitation attributed to Sulaiman alayhi salam through Ahmad al-Buni, Sheikh Ahmad al-Buni, Ash'ari Maliki, Sufi, Qutb of his time. Okay, through them attributed to Sulaiman alayhi salam. And even they do have some certain recitations as Azima Sulaimaniya, or Azima Sulaiman alayhi salam means recitation of Sulaiman. So after reading that, that's all I'm going to explain how it happens. After reading that, actually, you will have some tribe of jinnat in control. They will start helping and doing things for you. Anyway, so that is the hadith, that is the ayah. So Allah, as a response to them, to the priests and rabbis, Allah did say, Ma kafara Sulaiman. Sulaiman never made kufr, walakin ash-shayatin kafur. But the slaves of Sulaiman alayhi salam, the jinnat, after the death of Sulaiman alayhi salam, they made kufr. How? يعلمون الناس السحر ببابل. Okay? So يعلمون الناس السحر. So they started teaching the sihr to the people. Okay? And then, and there are many other ayat and ahadith actually about the sihr. So for example, one of them, if you remember, actually hadith is in Bukhari. Theologically, big group of people do not accept this hadith. If you remember, Labid ibn Asam Yahudi, okay, and how he made black magic to effect on Rasulullah. Okay, obviously there are two groups within Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Okay, some said Rasulullah was affected by black magic because of this hadith of Bukhari. The second group said Rasulullah was never affected. Okay, because they said if Prophet is so easily reachable by black magic, so then how do you know which part of Quran has been revealed under that effect and which one is not? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Wallahu ya'asimuka minan nas, Allah is going to protect you from the people. And means God couldn't fulfill His promise. Okay? As well as, if you remember when there was a conversation, debate, challenge between God and when Iblis challenged God, saying, I'm going to destroy them all. Okay? So Allah replied, saying, Laysa laka alayhim sultan. There are some group of chosen people of mine, you will be unable to touch them here. If Rasulullah is not one of them, so who is them? Okay, so actually, that both of the groups are from Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah. Okay, so anyway, so there are many ahadith and ayat about black magic. Now, because we do not have that much time, so now let's talk about the hukum of black magic, doing black magic. Again, two groups. One say doing black magic is kufr. Okay, why? Because if you remember Harut and Marut, two angels, this is in Surah Al-Baqarah, when they were teaching, people would come to learn black magic in Babylon, Iran. Okay, so what they would say, innaman ahlu fitnatun, we are only test for you guys, so do not become kafir. Okay, so the first group said, doing it and learning it is kufr. Why? Because it is in Quran. Because they did not say, don't disobey God, but they said, don't do kufr. How? By learning it. Okay? مَا يُعَلِّمَانِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ Do not, they wouldn't teach anyone to, like, they wouldn't teach sihr, black magic, to anyone, except by saying, إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ فِنَّا We are tasked only for you guys. فَلَا تَكْفُرْ So do not be kafir. Means learning black magic is kufr. Doing and learning black magic is kufr. So that's the first group. But the mu'taman position of Ahl Sunnah for Mazahib, we say that it is majority. We say it is not kufr, unless if you will start believing in it. So for example, do you know this water? So I'm thirsty. So if I drink it, it goes. Okay? Me feeling thirsty, it goes. Question now, how does it go? I say Allah removes it, and what is just one of the reasons. Allah can remove it even without water. But if I will start believing in it, saying Allah does not remove that, but actually this removes it. So that is kufr. So if you believe in black magic like that, saying, when I affect on the people, so I'm the one who is affecting independently, so that is kufr. But if a person believes that it is Allah who is the one, he is the one who is doing it, creating it, but this recitation is just normal reason. So that is not kufr. Okay, so anyway, so doing kufr or learning it, according to the majority of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, is a major sin. But is it kufr? We see that is not kufr. But what about that ayah in which Allah says, فَلَا تَكْفُرْ? So we say it means that normally, it is the Sabbath Rasulullah said, the distance between a Muslim and kufr is namaz. Anyone who leaves it, means very close. So straight after that, next is kufr. Means by learning it, you will fall into the kufr, no doubt. Because I did meet many people who do black magic, so they will start believing in it. Because each time when you do, you see its effect. So you will start believing in it. So that causes kufr. Okay? So, fala takfur means do not become kafir by learning and practicing it. Because if you will carry on practicing, you will each time you will see its effect. Then you will start believing in it. So that is kufr. Okay, so it leads to kufr. As well as in terms of Imam Razi, Fakhruddin Razi, his Shafi'i scholar, he made very strange statement. Okay, I remember when I read it the first time, I was very shocked. I wouldn't expect it from such a great scholar as Fakhruddin Razi. But actually, I understood that he has got a very big share of truth in what he said. So he said, learning black magic is wajib. In Shafi'i, wajib means hard. Do I have Shafi'is? You see, all of them are Shafi'is, but they're scared. Because we'll just seal this, but all of them. I say, Zindabad Fakhruddin Razi. Why? He said, because look, black magic, it is not only something that you learn between you and God, but it is going to have public consequences. Public consequences. So Fakhruddin Razi said, it is fard kifaya. At least one person in one locality has to learn, has to be an expert of it. Why? Because look, because there is a punishment for the black magician. Amara, he will be jailed. Some of them will be jailed forever.
Okay, but if he, the person will cause black magic to kill someone, who will take revenge from him? Okay, so Fakhruddin Razi said, for us to apply the Islamic punishment on the black magician, first of all, we have to know that the thing that he's doing is black magic or not. Because in our time, everyone is black magician. Why? The only one reason is if you hate him, that's it. You are sheikh, you are speaker, you are not person. You hate someone, you just say, people will believe you. Why? Because there are no people who will know what black magician is. Did you understand? They don't know what is the subject of black magic. Okay? So for example, I'm Hanafi, I say, learning black magic is haram, it is major sin. Okay? But deep down in my heart, I do have, I'm convinced that there should be someone who can distinguish between real black magic and the fake one. Because 90% of the people who claim that they do know how to do black magic, they're just charlatans, they're liars. Okay? Do you want me to show how to do it? Okay? Look. Charlatans, obviously, they use the way of convincing. Because this helps to convince the people. Okay? So, it is how false charlatan black magicians do. Okay, so, take him from here. Yeah, so, step on the can I have? Oh! Okay. I can see my face. Okay, who's it? Are you with him also? Okay. So that's what black magic is. But it is way of charlatans. Okay? What do? They just want to get fancy. But do you know the real black magicians, they will never show themselves. Okay? So for example, when people come to me with the black magic, okay, so after checking, you see many people, many charlatans doing all business just to get paid. But one will be you. How you see it? When you read the text which is included into the person. Only then you realize that he is the real black magician. Okay? So, in Muslim land, charlatans will not be given the punishment of the real black magician. But what they will be done? So, Qazi will announce their names in the bazaar, in the market, saying he's a liar. Some of the Qazis even used to do to make the person to sit all the way around him, on the donkey, and to make him to go around the market, saying he's a liar. So that is the punishment of the liar. But the punishment of the real black magician sometimes can reach to the execution. Why? Because black magician normally can kill the good people also. And each single black magician, at least till his death, will kill at least about 10-15 people. But so for us to apply the punishment, we have to be 100% confident that he is real, not the charlatan. Okay? As well as, look, the charlatans, they just may write different things, you know. Once, actually, someone came to Dewsbury, charlatan. People, they have been cheated very badly, you know. Everyone, you know, just, they went, they paid him, etc. So then I went without these black magician clothes, you know. Just a proper city boy. Obviously, I look very beautiful, you know, in like a city boy clothes, you know. Yeah, so, yeah, so it's like a Hollywood, but Uzbek mood, you know, it's handsome. So I went to him, he asked me my name. I said, my name is Muhammad. Obviously, I was concerned that if he's real, straight away he will understand what I am. So I said, my name is Muhammad. Okay, so then he started writing things. I understand the new Muhammad, you know. He, first of all, he just has converted the name of Muhammad into the numbers incorrectly. After that, he asked my date of birth. Okay, so I gave him my real date of birth. When I saw that he's a charlatan, so I said, I'm really not concerned, just take everything clear. Okay. And then after that, what he did, He just, let's say that my date of birth is, for example, 5th of January, okay, 19, for example, because I want to make my age to be 16 years old, so what is it going to be? Because that's my real age, you know? So, for example, 1980, for example. So then he started just adding one to the other. It never happens like that, you know? Okay, so for example, 1, 9, 8, 0. So what did he do? So it is 1 plus 9 plus 8 plus 0. That's incorrect. So black magic is not like that. Okay? Or even checking, making check is not like that also. Okay? So first you have to bring the name of the person and his mother's name and all of that things. And after that, you have to make it on the odd way. Okay? So but he did everything incorrectly. And after that, he did his started working. Because the person who has got evil eye, if you are only a person, when you touch him, you will work naturally. Naturally, you know? So then he started working out. He said, you know. So I'm saying, I do not have any evil eye, I'm going to work because you make it. So anyway, so then he made all of those things. Then he said, you have to change your name. You know, there was a story. Some doctor went to very far village, and there was a herbalist, very well known herbalist in that locality. But he was also charlatan. But the new doctor, contemporary medicine, he was new. So when he came, he found some patient. So what was the case with him? While he was eating, so he was eating very fast bread, dry bread. And when he had eaten it, so you know, his jaw came off. So the herbalist, the famous herbalist, do not enema, like a liquid. They put water with like a different like things in it, antibiotics, etc. And then they push it from the anal way. So he came and he made like, he said that you have to get the enema 3 times a day. So, same thing I had with this shower bar. So, first of all, like making like a, make it up on my name, correct, just plus, what is plus. And after that, you know, so then verbally, all of that thing to convince me, okay, just to go into my trust. And after all of that, I see that you have to change your name. My name is very light for me, especially for my personality. Muhammad is too light also, you know. His name is light for me. So I don't know, I didn't see it. I mean, but it was good. Good like, do you know Mr. Bean? Like a new episode. Mr. Bean, I keep Mr. Bean, you know. The new episode. Okay? So 90% of the people who are playing me, that they are magicians, or even the dead people, they are liars. They don't know what they're doing. But because we, in our time, we are very ignorant, and we are very emotional, and we are very, like, you know, the ill person, you'll be desperate, you know. So then, so because of that, we will have all of them liars next to us, you know. So that's why Imam Razi said, God bless him. This is just a brilliant point. We have to know what black magician is and what black magic is, or otherwise we may apply punishment on the liar. And the punishment of the liar is not the same as punishment of the new one. Do you understand? Okay? But I see the point of the Hanafis also, because do you know, when you learn it, even with good intention, afterward it becomes evil. Because human being naturally is evil and good. Most of us are evil. Okay, we love money, we love power, we love fame, we love women. So we do have that. 99.99 of us, we do have that. Okay? So the equipment of all of them things in your hand, you will apply it. You will use it. Okay, so that's why. But in the same time, I say there should be some subject which teaches you what black magic is. But not the actual thing, but just around. Okay. So anyway, that's it back to six. Now, in terms of in terms of types. Maybe in total, we have over 20 different types of black magic, but I'm going to just mention a few. Obviously, the first one, it is Sihr al-Tafriq, it is mentioned in the Quran. Black magic of separation, it is actually in the Quran. What do? They separate couples, husband and wife, from each other. They separate friends from each other, as well as they separate business partners from each other. Believe me, I have seen very respected, like, seven business people getting engaged into this also. So if you would see them, in your mind you would say, oh, brilliant, millionaire. Great person, but he will do this kind of thing because competition and the enmity is the reason of black magic. Enmity and competition. So the business in which they are running millions, it causes greatest envy. So business people, to get rid of each other, they do this kind of thing. Okay. So two, for example, friends doing business company together. So you are on your own. To destroy them, do Sihr al-Tafriq, you separate them. Okay? So then everything goes wrong. Okay? And normally what happens in this type of Sihr al-Tafriq, will make you to feel bad towards that person, creating doubts in your mind. Okay? So for example, let's suppose that me and you, we are partners, business partners, and you are affected by Sihr al-Tafriq. So my normal acting towards you, you will receive it negatively. For example, if the Eid, I will send you a gift. So because you're affected by black man, straight away you think, okay, so he gave me this gift and he is willing to do something. So that's how it starts. Okay, between husband and wife, so let's suppose that I will marry some lady and someone wants to separate us, so they will affect on both of us. So I will see her properly, she's beautiful, okay? Each single thing that she does, for me it will be so evil. As well as when I see her next to her, I will feel tension. Anything can burn off that anger, temper. Okay, but when I am far away, I'm happy. When I come close, I do have that tension. Okay? So, for example, the problems from nothing. Okay? So, for example, just a tea was leaked. Oh, it causes big problems. Okay? Or, for example, there was not enough spicy. I think all of the brothers that have been affected by black magic on this side. So, if it's not enough spicy, it causes big friction, fighting, etc. Okay? And from that side also. From her side also, she sees anything ugly from me. Okay? So for example, there was even a case in which lady, you know, you know, her husband was a very handsome person, and there is no ugly man, as well as there is no ugly lady. But we may have different tastes. So it was a very handsome person, like a mushroom. So, but then the problem was that he has hairs on his face. Even after shaving, so for her it should be smooth. Straight away to black hair. Because man is like that. It is the nature of man that we do have hairs on our face. Okay? So anything from husband would be evil, ugly, and negative. Okay? Even if it is just small, miserable things. Okay? So that is one thing. As well as there is a different type of black magic. It is black magic which, again, to separate the different ones from each other, they do it to prevent, to stop the sexual intercourse. So first, sexual intercourse never happens. Why? Because if husband is infected, so erection will not be there. Okay? Healthy person, there is no mental problems, everything is in place, but erection will not happen. He will go to other places, it is there, but when he comes back to his wife, it's not there. Okay? Or even, erection will be there, but he will be unable to fulfill. Okay?
that ladies' virginity, it will be like elastic. It will be unable to be destroyed. So that is normal, that's not black magic. But in our case, it does not go past it, you know. Because even if connection is very strong. Why? Because it is black magic. Okay. That is about man. And about the lady, same thing will happen. Suddenly, some piece of flesh will grow. Sometimes physical condition, but physical condition will come from long before, but not exactly in the night of her marriage. Okay, or she will start bleeding continuously, it never stops. Okay, or for example, legs will be attached to each other, it will be, they will be unable to like open it. So they will be unable to fulfill the sexual intercourse. Why? Because it's again, they want to separate them from each other. All of them is very easy. Very easily destroyable thing. So do not get scared. Okay? But most of the time, young people, especially at Lisbon, he will be ashamed. Especially when he has like a problem with like a erection, so he will be ashamed. He will think that it is because of like illness, or it's his thing. So he will never come to explain it to his parents. Okay, but you shouldn't be ashamed of that thing. It is very natural, it's very normal. So it's not your fault, but it is the fault of that enemy who is making black magic. So do not be ashamed of this kind of thing. Okay? Again, as I said, no any black magic can be stronger than Surat Yasin for 40 times read within 3 days. I'm going to explain that. Obviously, everything has got its own ayah or its own dua. Yeah? Okay? But Surat Yasin for 40 times is for everything. Okay? Merely for everything. As well as there is black magic also which causes love. Okay? So normally it happens, let's suppose, if you are, well, it will never happen with you guys, because if you are handsome as myself, so it could happen to you, but not to you guys. So some lady will fall in love with some young man. But that young man is not attracted to her. So what she will do black magic to create a love. Okay? As well as it could be from other way. Okay? So young man can do it on the ladies to attract her love towards himself. Okay? It is very common also. Okay? As well as it happens between the husband and wife also. Mainly ladies, they do it. Okay? So, because ladies, for some reason, they're very jealous, you know? They're very jealous. And also, they think that we do go to marry someone else. Okay? So then, if that doubt falls into her mind, that is finished. Okay? After that, your life is never going to be well as it used to be before. So that doubt, it doesn't matter if it's from the lady or from you. So your life is over, your game is over. Okay, so then she will start doing that type of black magic. Okay? So first thing, let's suppose that once you came back in your house, okay, and maybe you were sitting on the chair where some lady was sitting before you, so you may come from one hand on your floor. Okay? So then she will find it. That is the beginning of the end. What she will do, she will go to the black magician to make hisab on your name. As I said, most of them are charlatans. Straight away, he will say that you have 5 girlfriends and you are willing to marry 3 of them as you have one in your house, so forth altogether. So that's it. And why does he do it? Why does he lie? Because he needs money. And ladies trust these type of things, you know. They trust charlatans because they say what ladies want to hear. They will start paying money. I want to stop that magic. I want my husband to fall in love with me. Okay? One thing from our side, our wives, every day they want to hear that we love them 5 times a day. The day in which we do not say it, we say it only once, straight away they will start thinking that thing. So that is the error that's coming from them, you know? So they will straight away go to the magician. They shouldn't trust magicians. All of them are charlatans. They are after our money. After our money. Okay? So anyway, and then they will do. So do you know that loving it's actually it did happen even in the time of Sahaba, okay, with the so it affects, so it creates a love, but it's not very easy to control that love, you know. So black magician should be very high expert to make that love to be only to this lady. It could be just nearly uncontrollable because you cannot control your hand easily. Okay, you can make him to fall in love, but with whom? It's very difficult. Okay, so then he may start loving everyone or some other lady. Okay, so then just finish. So our advice to the ladies as well as to the brothers: stop doubting. Stop doubting your husband. Anyway, so that is another thing. As well as one of the most destructive type of black magic is the black magic of doubt, actually. Okay, it causes doubt all the time about everything and about anything. There is a normal psychological condition which happens without black magic also. Like a naughty person will be, you know, the people who like have a metal sword, they will keep on washing their face, thinking that there is. So the same thing could be caused by black magic also. I would say maybe that is the most difficult black magic, nearly incurable, unless if you are very strong and you have patience, long-term patience. So because normally after curing your patient, he will still have that habit of doubting. So whenever you doubt, you will start doubting, making negative thoughts about people, you become weak. Okay, so spiritually you become weak. Okay, so then you are very easily affected. Again and again and again. So it's nearly incurable. Okay, so because you have to first kill the black magic, and after that you have to convince, you have to work with the patient psychologically. You have to stop, you have to make him to stop thinking evil about things. Okay, so he becomes a negative person. And as we know, it is like beginning, bad thoughts is beginning of the Saudawi illness. Saudawi illness is mainly oncologic illnesses. Okay, so cancer. So do not, for example, so all of the negative things will carry on gathering in the mind, and then it will just affect yourself. Okay, so heart problems, stomach problems, wound in the stomach. Okay, nerves will be killed, destroyed. Okay, so many that type of things. In terms of how do they affect the way of affecting. I really wouldn't like to mention it in here because we all become skeptical, but don't worry. As I said, black magic is a very weak thing. It's a very weak thing. So what do they do in terms of affecting? Black magic could be affected. It could affect you through what you eat, okay, or what you drink, okay, or what you wear, or something that belongs to you. Okay, they may pick up anything, your hair, okay? Or for example, even there are people who can affect your saliva also, okay? As well as your clothes, okay? Or there are people who can affect your pictures also, okay? And also they may feed you, the most common is feeding. As well as people, they write things on the paper, okay? And then they may just throw it in your house. But normally when they come, they put it in their places, hidden places. For the hidden away. So hidden places that you cannot find, okay? So mainly it is in the kitchen room. Okay? So things that you never expect. Okay? You know, the very well-off Rupia people, they can work out where it is. Okay? As well as, you know, the, you can do it by yourself also. Make sure, for example, when you are spiritually high, okay, just walk into your rooms. The room in which you feel down, tension, so means most likely it needs to be there. Okay, so that is the thing. As well as they may do it on the dust. On the dust, it's very common also, because that is very, so they read it, okay, the black magic, and then they just throw it in front of your gate. When you come out of your house, no doubt you just step on it. Now you are just gone. Okay, so that is another thing. Yeah, as well as another very most common and very
very effective. Quickest one is one of the quickest ones is your name and your mother's name. Do you know, in terms of the spiritual healing as well as spiritual evil, for both of them, your name and your mother's name will be used. Okay, if you remember, Rasulullah came. So Sayyidah Fatima, it is narrated, but in Musnad of Khomeini. So Sayyidah Fatima had a problem, pain in her teeth. She came complaining to Rasulullah. So Rasulullah did put this finger, index finger, on top of the tooth, which is which has a pain. And then Rasulullah read dua, and then he said, Fatima bint Khadija, and then carried on reading. Okay, as well as Al-Hafiz al-Hadith, Al-Muhibbu al-Tabari, very famous Hadith scholar, he used to do the same thing. Anyone would come to him about pain in the teeth, he would put the index finger on the teeth and ask the patient, what's your name and your mother's name? Okay, why? Because that's how it works. Okay, for example, everything has got its own way. For example, do you know eye print for the identity? Do you know that? Okay, or for example, fingerprint. Okay, so that is for the criminal things. I'm Arab, but in normal circumstances, it is your name and your surname. Okay, as well as for the spiritual healing, as well as spiritual, like calm, black magic, and evil eye. Black magic, they use your name and your mother's name. How? That's how it works, you know. But so it's not necessary that if someone asks you for your name and your mother's name, that he's going to benefit you, because he can harm you, as well as other way around. Okay? So as hadith is there, as well as Mhmd Adnan Darwish, inshallah, at the end, if I was a chance, I will give you that dua. Experience is tested for many times, it works. Okay, and normally, after taking your name and your mother's name, they specify a period also. Mhmd al-Tabari would ask, for how long time do you want these pain to go? They would say 2 years. So then they would read the dua, and then they would say, Fulan bin Fulana, for 4 years. That's it. Pain goes, and it comes back only after 4 years. So, for the spiritual field, your name and your mother's name. That's how it works. Okay, so just someone asking you for your mother's name, it does not mean that he's a magician. As well as it does not mean that he's a nuclear person. Because that could be used for anything related to the spiritual field. Okay, so anyway. So what do they do? They just take your name. So when your name and your mother's name is gone, that's it, you are gone with it. Okay, so now they can do any type of black magic could be done through your name and your mother's name. Okay, numerology, okay, as well as the letters, because it is with him now. As well as they may attach different types of the jinnat to you. Okay, it will get them confusing or scary, etc. So all of that is doable after you will disclose your name and your mother's name. So that's why try to keep it away. Okay, try to keep it unknown. Okay, so in terms of maybe the last thing that we can talk about, what does it, what will happen?
How long? 15 minutes.
Okay, now in terms of all the lecture.
In the whole lecture, about 3.5 hours.
Sorry?
3.5 hours.
3.5 hours. So we have Evil and
Jinnat as well, yeah.
Okay, inshallah, I will see. After completing all of them topics, I may give you some du'as, inshallah, just to protect yourself. Anyway, now in terms of symptoms of black magic, symptoms of both of black magic and evil eye, as well as you being infected by jinn, nearly the same. Okay, it's 90% exactly the same. So, in terms of black magic, so normally black magic and evil eye will not convert into the physical illness until if it is very old. Very fresh one, it will never affect on the physical side straight away. Means you may find pain, okay? But it will never become illness unless if it's very old. It stays with you for a long time. Long time means
starting from 5 up to whatever. Okay? But anything less than 5 maybe. Okay? So the short-term evil eye or black magic, it never becomes real, like a physical illness. Means when you go to the doctors, they will find nothing. But if it stays for longer than you find, they find something. They find illness. Okay? So for the black magic and evil eye to effect, to become real physical illness, it should stay with you for a very long time. Okay? Some of them may stay even 10, 15 years before it becomes real illness. Okay? But before that, it will stay as just normal pains here, there, and you feel not comfortable, and that's it. Okay? Okay, so what are the symptoms? First of all is moving pain. Not pain, which is not in one place, but all the time moves. Okay, but then you go to doctors, nothing. For example, headache. Okay, next day throat, next day liver, next day stomach. That's how it will carry on moving. Okay, so that is a symptom for the black magic, as well as evil eye. And the second thing is heavy shoulders. Okay, heavy shoulders. Okay, and pain in this area. Okay, and it's heavy. Heavy in terms of you feel some like it's tense, you know, like tension. So it's heavy. You feel it heavy. Okay, that is another. And a third symptom is a lower back pain. Normally, lower back pain, it is the people who have a sciatica, for example, who sit a lot, drivers, taxi drivers. Okay, or for example, office people, because they sit a lot, so they do have a lower back pain. Okay, but if you do not have it, so it's not normal for you to have a lower back pain, but in the black mesh you will have it. Okay, so there will be pain as well as urine infection with the ladies, very common. Okay, so urine infection. But urine infection, which is, they will find like burning, but when they go to the doctors, again, nothing. Okay, they will give, for example, a painkiller, so it stops the pain for a short while. As soon as you will stop taking the painkiller, again it comes back. So it is black magic, as well as it could be evil eye also. As well as one of them, a very obvious ones, very scary dreams. So what's the meaning of scary dream? Someone runs after you. Okay, someone runs after you. And you try to run, but you are vulnerable. It's running very quickly, but you're running very slowly. Okay, or for example, someone kills you and you feel that pain. Okay, as well as someone will push your chest, but you feel it real. Okay, it is a real thing. And you scream, you shout, but you are not shouting. There is no any sound, there is no any voice. You know, you are shouting, but nothing is coming out. You know, you want to move your hands, it's not moving. Your chest is very heavy. Okay. Or sometimes it could be that you will see in your dream someone will come to you saying it is in the poison of something in your house. Okay, so it is, and that's also another thing. Also, the people who see snakes in your dream, most likely that is black magic. Okay, a lot of snakes. Okay, or one big one, or very long one. Okay, or you may see it in wakeful status. Okay, long jinn. Okay, long like a snake, big one. Okay, as well as, do you know the type of black magic where some jinn will be attached to you? Sign of that, but all the time you feel tension. You feel presence when you're on your own. When you sit in a room, you feel that someone is looking at you. Some presence. Okay, some presence. You know, just I want to clarify one thing. This will happen with two types of people. One is who have been attached to the jinn, and the second is the people who have sire. If you know our elderly people, they say you have sire, you know? Okay, so sire is not harmful as the black magician jinn. Okay, so sire is not harmful. Okay, it could be positive. For me, it is positive thing. Okay, but this black magician is, you know, the jinn which is attached to harm you, that is harmful. But sahih is not harmful. Most of the time sahih is not harmful. Okay, so that is the,
These are the main symptoms of you having some type of black magic. Okay, most common types. Okay, again, as I said, black magic can stay after 40 times of Yasin. Okay, what's the meaning of 40 times of Yasin? Obviously, you will bring the person who is affected, so he cannot do it on his own, but it should be someone else. As well as the ruqya, for some reason, the strength of ruqya is not based on the strength of the ayah, but it is based on the strength of the person who is doing the, who is performing the ruqya. Sometimes it could be that by only reading Surah Al-Fatiha once, it's just cured. Because the person who is performing it is strong. Strong means spiritually he is well off. Does not have a habit of committing sins, etc. And he does a lot of awrat, so he's a strong person. Okay, just by reading once, finished. Okay, but even weak person, if he will read it, so 40 times it will bring to make him strong also. So nothing stays after 40 times. Even if you have some black effect of black magic, even after Yasin being read 40 times, means that it's only illusion or you being used to the black magic, so you are feeling it, still you are feeling it, but it is not in them. Okay? So how to do it? Obviously you bring the person who is affected by black magic, and it is recommended to have a water also, because you will blow on the person as well as on the water, and you will make him to drink the water as well as to have a shower. As well as this is very powerful water, when you spray it everywhere, if there are some jinnat, it will just burn them off. So that water is very, very effective. Okay, so what do? You read Surah Yasin 40 times. If you are on your own, and if you are altogether 10, means you will read it only 4 times, because altogether becomes 40. Okay, and you can read it separately, each of you on your own, or collectively, together. Okay, and after, because we do have 7 mubins in Surah Yasin. Okay, after each single mubin, you blow on the person and you blow into the water. Okay, look, there is 2 different types of blowing. One is when you blow, you do suf, sod and fa, and one shin and fa, shuf and suf. Okay, so what is the difference? The difference it is if it is in the beginning stage. So there is no any physical illness, so we do suf, salt and fa. But if it became black magic, long-term one, it became into the illness, cancer patient, for example. You do shin and fa. Okay, so that's the difference. Okay? Maybe some of you may ask, where did you get this bid'ah from? Where Prophet said it? Where? I said, look. For example, you getting operation from the surgery. Where Prophet did say that? Prophet did not say that nowhere. Am I right? But Rasulullah said, Tadawu ya ibadallah. Get treated, all slaves of God. Okay? And the rest has been derived by the people of that field, doctors. Ibn Sina and all of them doctors. So that's how we do have its own doctors in our field. You don't like what I'm saying, but take it. But it's field. I mean, people of its field, they dictate the same 40 times and as I explained. Okay? And my proof from hadith is, if you know Rasulullah, that person in that journal, hadith in Bukhari, group of sahab, they went to their trade. And when they were coming back, in one of the places, there was some Bedouin tribes, so they were very hungry. So they said, please can you host us? Who are hungry. So they said no, greedy people. And the leader of the tribe, he had some problem. Scorpion harmed him, okay? So then they came. These people came to the Sahaba saying, do you have any Raqi who makes you clear? They said yes, one of the Sahaba. And then he went to read Fatiha, and then he blown on the leader, and then actually he was cured straight away. So then, as a payment, they gave them, they gave Sahaba a lot of gold and sheep. So before touching it, Sahaba said, we don't know if its payment is halal or not. So don't touch it, let's take it to the Prophet. So when they came to Medina, they explained, Ya Rasulullah, so and so happened, we have been paid. So it's okay if we eat it, even though if you have been paid for Quran, for that, okay. They said the most halal things that you get, the most halal payments that you get is the payment for Quran. So take it, take the payment, as well as give me my share of Rasulullah as a gift. So, and then Rasulullah after that, he called the Sahabi who made the ruqya. He said, how do you know that Fatiha, Surah Al-Fatiha is ruqya? Sahabi said, ulqiya fi ru'i, it was thrown into my mind. We have two proofs in here. Obviously, if you're like a narrow-minded, understanding person, it is not proof for you, just stay aside. But for us, it is proof. First thing, Rasulullah saying, how do you know that Fatiha is ruqya? From here, we know that not all of Quran is ruqya, but specific surahs, ruqya, not only that, but our scholars say, specific ayat is ruqya for specific illnesses. Okay, that's one thing. From this, and the second thing, it was whispered, it was thrown into my mind. So when we say the sayyid business, it is coming from here. Okay, because he never studied. And what is thrown into his mind, Rasulullah says, Inna lil malaki bibni Adam al-amma wa inna lil shaytani bihi lamma. So, angel has a whisper, lamma. Angel has a whisper to a human being as well as the shaytan has a whisper. Okay, anyway, inshallah, in the lecture about the jinnat, inshallah, we'll talk about that. Okay, so anyway, so from here we know, we prove two things. One is, what is ruqya? It's not everything is ruqya for everything, but some of the surahs and ayat is not ruqya, but even it is still Quran. Okay, one thing, and the second thing, the business of sa'i, the issue of sa'i. It was whispered into my mind, okay, that it is ruqya. Okay, so for example, sometimes you go to the patient, obviously you are a person who are praying five times a day and you are not doing major sin. When you go to the patient, somehow it comes to your mind that he has got this problem. So go with it. But look, distinguish between your own thought and the thought that hits your mind as like an emission. So the first one is the real one and the second is your own thought. Ignore the second. Anyway, we'll talk about that after. So from here we understand that which surah to be read and how to read. Okay, it's not something that you just pick up Quran from any Sahih al-Bukhari and then you say Haddasana Bukhari an fulan an suf. It never works. Everything has got its own way and its own surahs and ayah. If you never learn that, you will receive what I'm saying as black magic. It's not because this is black magic, but because you're ignorant. That is that. Okay. So that is actually the thing. Yeah. No, okay, that's fine. So look, so in each mubin, okay, in Surah Yasin, you stop and you blow on the patient and in the water also. So that how 40 times. Okay, so because it is 7 mubins, means you do suf 8 times. Because the last mubin, it's not at the end of the Surah Yasin, but after that 3-4 extra ayat. So even after that you do 8 suf on the person and in the water also. And after that, you should make the patient to carry on drinking that water and taking a shower. How to do with the water? So when you put your mouth once, all of that becomes one. So even if it is 5 liters, so that's why you shouldn't drink it straight from that, but put it into the water. Because as soon as you put your mouth once, so all of that is just for one using. Do you understand? Or otherwise you can carry on putting into the glass of water and mixing it with big jug of water and all of that is still same strength. It will have the same strength of the thing. Yeah. Which one? Yeah, so because look, for example, normally as a treatment from black magic and evil eye, it will stay for either 3 days. If it's not cured, so then 7. If it's not, then 9, 11, or 21, or 40 days. So within that period, patient needs something. So that is the water. Take shower to drink. So let's suppose that you was blowing into 5 liters jug. Within 3 days, your patient wasn't cured. So either you have to repeat it again if your patient finished off the water, or
these 5 liters water, slowly, slowly mix, for example, one cup of that mixed with another 5 liters and use. So the strength is equal. It does not get decreased. Unless if you finish off all of the water, when you put a new water and there was not any water in there, now this new water, there is nothing in there. You understand? Okay? So all of that is actually based on the experience. You like it, take it. You don't like it, don't say it's wrong, it's bid'ah. Okay? Because same thing, you getting paracetamol. It's bid'ah according to your analogy. But the people of its field, they know. فَسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ. Ask the people of that knowledge. Ask the people of that field. Okay? So that is actually what we normally do. And keep in your mind, no any type of black magic can stay after them 40 yasins. Okay? If anything is staying, so most likely it is because of a person not reading Quran properly. So properly means, so for example, when you go to sleep, we ask you to read Ayatul Kursi 7 times, Amara, because when you have mistakes, tajweedi mistakes, when you read it 7 times, all together will fulfill once, correct reading. Do you understand? Means, when you read Yasin 40 times, your pronunciation of Quran should be so damaged that when you are reading it, it's not fulfilling even once. Okay, so just get the local imam, he will read it and everything will be sorted. Okay, so inshallah, that is all about black magic, inshallah. We are going for a short break.